Greetings, friends. Sonic Toast here. We got a couple of fun new Super Mario playsets to open up, so I'll show you what all we got. So first of all, there is this. This is the Cloud World playset, and with that is also this, the diorama set, which is extra accessories that are meant to go with this, the main playset. Now, this is one that I was hesitant to get, and that's because of this, the fuzzy. I hate how Jack's Pacific has been doing characters simply printed or like a piece of cardboard or something like that. You know, they are a figure company. They should be making figures of the characters. That's why I was hesitant to get this one, but I ended up going for it. Also, we have this Lava Castle playset, which I think we'll just have to unbox next time. But for now, let's go ahead and get these ones open. We'll start with the big playset and see what all it has to offer. Here's how it looks on the inside. Got a lot of pieces here. So let's go ahead and get that put together. So here is the playset all put together, and it comes with a little running Mario figure. How many of these do we have now, right? So there is that. So let's take a look at some of the features. So this mushroom that Mario's standing on extends like so. And then the mushroom right behind him rotates. See it? That's about how far it goes. It's got some clicks in there, like click, click, left, click, click, right. So that's the moving mushroom. And then there is this cloud platform that doesn't do anything specific. It's just an extra platform there for Mario to stand on or run on or whatever. And then the ground might be my favorite part of this playset. This textured blue ground can be whatever you want it to be, honestly. We have this cloud background with the mountains in the back. Like I mentioned, I don't like that they printed fuzzy on the back there, and they printed the, you know, the chains or whatever it is that fuzzies go along on. I feel like if you're gonna have a character like Fuzzy be part of the playset, make him into a figure. Make him 3D. I hate the idea of just a flat character being there. And then there's the mushrooms themselves. We all know what Mario mushrooms look like. They have spots on top. They do not look like this with a solid color. They don't have spots on the stem or the trunk or whatever you would call this thing on a mushroom. Sometimes they have stripes and sometimes they're plain. I don't know why they mixed it up like this. Why didn't they put the spots on the top and just give it a plain trunk or give it stripes on the trunk? That would have been fine. But these do not look like Mario mushrooms. And yeah, it's a little disappointing that this is the first time we're really getting like big mushrooms as a playset for these Mario figures, and they just simply do not look right. Let's go ahead and we will add in the diorama, which goes with this. This is the cloud set diorama, and that is the wording that they use, of course, diorama. I'm sure a lot of you have seen the leak that there's a Sonic diorama set coming out, and it's going to be just like this. It's just going to be a couple characters and a couple items. It's not a playset or anything. Anyway, so here we have Copter Mario and Bullet Bill and Paragoomba. So repeat of three figures we already have. We get another cloud here, same one that came with the playset. But this is what really drew me to this diorama, was this, the Bowser flag. We've gotten the Mario flag in past playsets. However, I was not super satisfied with the Mario flag because it always fell down because it only had half of a base. This Bowser flag has the whole base. And let's check this out and see what it's like, because it's a lot longer than it shows here. It actually just had a piece of cardboard inside as a placeholder. So the actual pole should be around here somewhere. So here's one little tip. This is the background, little sky background it came with. The pole for the flag is taped underneath the cardboard. Took me a second to find it there. Now here is the Bowser flag all assembled, and we can compare it to the Mario flag that came, I think it's come in a couple different dioramas or playsets. And you can see they're basically the same toy. Yes, since the Bowser flag did come disassembled, you can disassemble it if you want to. And what I like the most about it is how well it stands. Whereas the Mario one, because it is only half of a base, it does not stand super well. whereas the Bowser one I feel is much more sturdy. The platform on top is much smaller, however, on the Bowser flag than on the Mario one, but it is also, oh wait, it's like a teeny bit longer, so you might actually be able to fit other figures on there. Here is the Paragoomba that came with the diorama set. I'm gonna go ahead and try to stick him on there, and he stays just fine. I've never been able to get a Goomba to stay on the Mario flag before, because it always seems to not fit. Oh, got him on. I got him on. It could be because Paragoomba. I've always tried with regular Goomba, and his wings could be his wings that's either balancing him or giving him something to hold on to. But yeah, that's cool. That's cool. Anyway, so there is that. Honestly, I think that is the main item that got me to buy this set, and it is the main reason to buy this particular diorama set. Because besides that, we get a Paragoomba, who you probably already have. I know I have one Paragoomba. And then we get Copter Mario again, who I know I have one Copter Mario in my collection, so now I have two Copter Marios and two Paragoombas. And then the last figure is Bullet Bill. Oh, I've got a handful of Bullet Bills I know in my collection. I'm sure you do too. One thing I don't like about Bullet Bill is he doesn't have a stand. He does not have a stand, so Bullet Bill just goes wherever you want him to sit. And the last item is another Cloud, which you can put wherever you want. There's not another spot to click it into on this playset, but you can put it wherever. So there we go. So friends, overall, this has been the diorama set for the Super Mario Cloud World or Sky World, whatever you'd like to call it. And so these are both pieces, the diorama set and the playset together. The background is the background that came with Princess Peach's castle, in case you were wondering about that. Overall, this set feels kind of lazy to me. It feels like they didn't pay enough attention to detail because of the mushrooms. The fuzzy, like I mentioned before, is something that I'm not fond of because it's just printed on the background there, whereas I'd much rather have an actual figure of fuzzy. So I do not like that, and that's the same reason why I did not get the Haunted Mansion playset, because the boos were just printouts. The figures, well, how great would it have been if they did, like, Copter Luigi or Copter Toad instead of just including Copter Mario again? Yeah, I know he's the main character and he's, like, the selling point, but it's a figure that we already had. You know, even if they wanted to keep him but have some kind of exclusive figure like a Fuzzy or a Copter Luigi or Copter Toad or you know, Yellow Toad or Blue Toad, that would have been great. Again, the mushrooms kind of ticked me off because they don't look like Mario mushrooms. Mario mushrooms are so iconic with the spots on top, and these are missing the spots, and the stems are not correct either. So overall, it's an okay playset. I do like when they do environments for these Mario set of figures, but this is just not my favorite. Acorn Plains is definitely my favorite, and some of the lava castles and dungeons, those ones are pretty good. I have not brought myself to get any of the underwater ones because I don't like the flat printout characters, and I have not brought myself to get the Haunted Mansion because, again, I don't like the flat printout characters. This is the first time I think I've bought one that has a character printed on the background, which, again, I simply do not like. Anyway, so that is that. Friends, let me know what you think in the comments section below. Now as a quick bonus, I finally got Star Power Luigi from the World Nintendo set. Yes, I found him on eBay. So let's get this guy unboxed and we'll add him in really quickly. So here he is, the same old running Luigi sculpt we've gotten 3 times now. But yeah, this is a figure that I just completely missed when it was released, so I had to find this guy on eBay. Wasn't too bad of a deal. I paid about $12 plus shipping for him. And yeah, now I have this Luigi as part of my collection too. So friends, have a wonderful day, and let me know in the comments section, what other Mario locations do you want to see as a playset from Jak's Pacific? I know they're doing a desert, I know there's a dungeon level one that I kind of want to get, and yeah, let me know if you want to see me review more playsets, because there's definitely at least one more coming up, and that is going to be this one, so toast.